Star Wars The Black Series, Rey and Dio from Rise of the Skywalker review. There's Rey on the box, Gregory Titus doing the artwork yet again, number 91 in the line, Rey and Dio. On the back of the box, if you want a freeze frame, you can read really just the sentence, doesn't tell you anything, and lots of other stuff there. There's some bits about Dio, a little roller that becomes fixated upon BB-8. There's the UPC, should you need it. I picked this up at DarkSideToys.com, where I get most of my toys. If you click the link below the video, you can go and pick it up from there. They've got stock at this wave. If not, link to eBay further below that. We'll do some comparisons to previous Rays, but first of all, let's just get a closer look at the figure and the accessories that it comes with. In fact, let's look at Dio overall. The first thing I think I want to make sure you know is look inside the pack before you throw it away. There is a small stand for Dio. It's a tiny little piece of plastic and very hard to miss. But if you put that small piece of plastic down and then put Dio on top of it, oops, he will, as I had him earlier on, stand. So you do have an ability to have a figure stand for him. Interesting little droid. Without it, he just really does not stand at all. So you do need that little piece. The figure itself, let me just showcase a little bit more. Nice weathering on him. He's got this little roller as it goes around there, which is quite nice. He also has, I think he had articulation in the head, didn't he? Yes, he does. He has a swivel head up at the top. It's on a little ball joint, I should say, so that allows all sorts of movement. He also has articulation at the back. We have three little antenna here, and they're on ball joints too, so they can move into different kind of poses, whatever they may be. And he's got these very cute little eyes at the front there, and his nose there with the green on the grill that he has. So nicely done. They've really done a lot of nice work on a very small piece of plastic, which is quite nice. They've really paid attention and done a very good job. So kudos Hasbro. Don't think anyone could have done that any better with that weathering, etc. So good job. Like it a lot. Now, let me put him back in his stand and we'll get him out of the way. Oops. In fact, we'll just lay him down and let's get on with Rey. So that's Dio out of the way. Rey's lightsaber is similar to the previous releases that she's had before in terms of colour. You can see there's one of the previous Rays we've had there. A little bit darker blue on this new version. Different on the hilt overall, it looks to be. I'm not really up on my lightsabers as to which one it was. Maybe this was one Luke gave her, I can't remember. But a different one, but you can see there's Luke's lightsaber and there's her lightsaber. So she's obviously maybe made one herself on her path to be a Jedi. So it's slightly different overall on that design of it, but the blue is fairly solid and blue overall. That is a separate piece, so you can carefully detach it. It will come off, but it's just, there you go. So it's quite a long male connector there into that female joint, but it will go on there. She doesn't have any grip for that to kind of hook onto anywhere, so it is what it is. She's got her blaster again that Han Solo gave her, nicely sculpted. I don't really see, let me compare to a previous one, and let me see if there's any real difference in those. Now this is a metallic one, so it will be slightly different, the one below. Let's have a little look. And it really doesn't seem to be a great deal of difference. In fact, I think it is different actually. You can see the finger slot there is closed on that previous version. This one is not. Handle doesn't have any sculpt or grip on that one. This one does. A little bit of black there, but that one does not. On the other side, much difference again. And apart from that little wedge up at the top in the finger hole, you can see that this is preferably, probably the best of the blasters so far. She had it one other time, I think. Let me just double check on this other one that we've got here. Yeah, so it has actually been used before. It is the same as one of the versions. I can't remember which one it was. I think this was Island Journey Rey. She got the better blaster overall. So there we go. So the diecast metal one really didn't cut it. So there you go. And that fits pretty nicely into a working holster, which you can see here. There we go. And that pops in nicely there onto her belt and looks very good indeed, might I add. So facial sculpt, let's get a look at this. Now, probably the one of the more recent Rays, not a great comparison there. She's looking really miserable there. This one doesn't really capture Daisy Ridley, I think, but it's still a very nice facial scan. Little too happy for, I guess, the kind of the mood of the movie, but it's not too bad. Kind of fairly plain-ish, but with a little wry kind of smile. There's Island Journey Ray there, and again, you know, not a million miles away. Hair pretty much, well, kind of the same, but different in those little buns that she's got going on. And I don't have the original Ray head anymore. I just have the mold of the body, but it's using, so I can't compare it, but the first original Ray was pretty bad. I'd swap the head here for one of the later, I think it was the Island Journey Ray head there. So, yes, can't compare to the original, but it really wasn't great. This one is pretty good. Not too bad. Again, the hair sculpt looks nice. Lots of nice intricate details. And those little wisps there. We don't have that original version, which had bits of plastic hanging down. This is nicely sculpted into the face. And it looks good. What do you think? That's kind of a little bit more Daisy Ridley there at that angle. So it captures it at certain ways and at certain angles as the light hits it. There seems to work for me. I think that looks pretty good. So it's not too bad at all. It's not too bad. Looks a little different in package, but certainly I do like the facial scan. They can be a little bit realistic, more than some people expect. A friend of mine was saying it kind of creeps them out a little bit how realistic they are. So there you go. Good kudos for that. On the previous Rays, we've never really had her backpack properly. I'm just looking at the other Rays here. No, we really have never had a Ray that's properly had a backpack there. I think one was molded into the sculpt of the figure, but nice to get to see this separate piece, which is kind of good. Doesn't really sit well on the figure. It kind of wobbles around a lot, but this hood does lift up at the back and it kind of stops that moving around. So you may prefer to do that to kind of just keep it in place and keep it a little bit more positioned. But either way, it's nice to have that kind of extra component or extra piece on the figure overall. Holster, we mentioned pike or pole, whatever you want to call it. This one is a little bit different to the previous ones. Let me grab one from, there's one from Island Journey Ray. So quite a different strap overall, that one, that very mustard colour. This one's a much greener colour in this newer stance. This was all one piece and didn't have separate parts or rotating pieces. You can see if I turn this up the other way, the sculpt and the design is pretty much the same overall. There's no real differences to it, really. It's pretty much the same that she's got. The difference being this time is that this actually has a separate piece which pops out, which I don't quite know what's going to happen there. Lightsaber in there, maybe? Who knows? Dun, dun, dun. Don't know quite what's going on there. But and this also, there we go, detaches too. So double-bladed lightsaber, maybe? What might be happening here? I don't quite know what's going on. So that would be interesting. Let's see whether this pops out here. Excuse that noise. If we pop that in. Yeah, that does become a lightsaber. That could be something. You just don't know. Could it be? What do you think? Pure speculation, but there you go. The fact that the lightsaber, the lightsaber, there you go. The fact that the weapon does that suggests something's going on, I would think. Something's going to happen to this weapon of some kind. So, interesting. Be careful with this because just at that join there, it's very weak and very small. So, it could be a little difficult. On the figure itself, in terms of articulation on her, she's got a ball joint head up at the top. Quite good movement, actually not too bad overall, really free and moving around, no issues. I like that this is a glued on separate piece, this hood. It really does, looks a little better and sits a lot better on the figure too, as I mentioned. It looks like it's kind of really wedged in there with a big plastic piece that could have been perhaps a bit smaller, but it works. In terms of articulation on the arms, you can see it pretty much is solid and pretty good. Good kind of range of movement and motion. Good joints at the elbows, pretty high overall. Yep, I like it. Down to the wrists, got the swivel and the extra join there going on at them. Plenty of movement on the waist articulation, moving around. Pegs up at the top of the thighs, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, and rocking ankles, and pretty deep, reasonable peg holes there. It's a good figure. I think it just didn't jump out at a lot of people because it's so similar to many other Rays in the past, particularly the original Ray, which we had a couple of times in different ways, just different wraps and colours and tones. But the facial scan head, the DO figure that comes with it, this perplexing piece, which is kind of interesting, and the weapon and the new lightsaber hilt make it pretty cool. So not a bad figure at all. Again, Darkside Toys is the place that I picked it up. Link in the description below, and again to eBay if they've sold out, but I don't think they're going to sell it at this rate in a hurry. But there you go. Let us know what you think. The movie is around the corner, so we may be very happily surprised by this figure. But again, leave a note, let us know, give it a thumbsy up, and we'll see you for the next Black Series review coming right up.